In this next section, we'll look at ionic chain growth polymerization or addition polymers. In this first example, I'm going to use propene. The example on ChemWiki was 2-methylpropene. So this is just a different example of basically the same thing. So what we need to make this happen is some trace amount of acid. So the acid is just going to be a catalyst. And they'll do that several ways. One way is with boron trifluoride and water. So we just have a little bit of acid around, which makes the complex BFF. Here, that will release one of these protons. So if that happens, what we can get is this electron pair will come out and grab a proton, just like always, to give us the more substituted carbocation, an H. And now what can happen is this can actually react with itself. So if we have another molecule of the propene, this pair of electrons can come over and attack that positive charge to make the dimer, or the start of the polymer chain. And this can just continue. So this can react then with another propene, where this pair of electrons can come over and add to that to keep extending the polypropylene chain. And if you want to look at these and where each of the separate propenes are, you could take that same drawing like this. You've got a positive charge here at the end. And now you can see that here's the first set of three carbons, here's my second set of three carbons, here's my third set of three carbons. So as this keeps going, it keeps growing, and you can see each of the monomer units that were used to make up the new polymer. So then at the end of the reaction, one of the molecules of the BF3OH that's left over can come over and deprotonate, push that electron pair towards the positive charge to get rid of it, to make the Zaitsev, or the more substituted alkene. And now, this is just a trimer, right? So anytime we're making these polymers, you know, they're going to be huge, and so we're not going to draw a ton of versions of them. But this polymer then can be drawn like this, with an N here. And so if you look at your repeating unit, you've got 1, 2, 3 carbons in the repeating unit of the polymer. So that would be a way that you can show that this is a polymer, an N meaning an integer that we don't know the number of extending out. Now, if you look at your different steps, back here you had an initiation. So even though these aren't radicals, in polymerization we have the same sort of steps that we would have in radicals. So we initiated the reaction. All of these ones in the middle are all propagations, or chain growth. So these are all propagation steps, really, which are sometimes called chain growth steps. And at the end here, we have a termination. So we had our chain that was kept reacting, and then when it stopped, that's the termination step. So it's very similar to what we saw with radicals, and how we have these initiation of the radical, a propagation, and then termination.